A few weeks ago, in an online article, it was reported that New Line Cinema allowed the rights for the Iron Man film to lapse because the CEO of New Line Cinema thought that it was completely unrealistic to make a film about a flying suit because he felt that the suit was too heavy. So how heavy could the Iron Man suit be? In this video, I'm going to answer that question. Hi there, I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and in this video, I'm going to make an estimate on the mass of the Iron Man suit. Well, when it's in flight, there are two masses to think about. First of all, there's the mass of the person who is actually wearing a suit, and second of all, there's also the mass of the suit itself. Let's say that the mass of the person is somewhere between 50 and 80 kilograms. That ticks off that mass. What about the suit then? To calculate the mass of the suit, I'm going to make four assumptions to simplify the whole calculation. Number one, I'm going to assume that the surface area of the skin on the outside of the human body is 2 meters squared. Now, I'm not pulling this number out of thin air. I've actually got this number from a scientific paper. And this is the scientific paper which was published in 2015. And in the abstract for the paper, the very first line indicates that the human skin is an organ with a surface area of somewhere between 1.5 and 2 meters squared. For the calculation I'm doing here, I'm going to use the upper limit of this value. Number two, I'm going to say that the average thickness of the suit on someone while they're wearing it is 5 centimeters. Where am I getting this number? Well, I've got to make up a number, to be honest. I don't have an Iron Man suit that I can just check to get the actual number. And plus, I haven't built one yet, and I don't think anyone actually has built one. Of course, this number of 5 centimeters accounts for not only the metal or materials that are used to make the suit on the outside, but also what's behind that as well. Number three, I'm going to assume that the entire suit is made of a gold titanium alloy. Now, I'm aware that there are other materials you would need to make the suit, but I'm oversimplifying this and saying the entire suit is made from this alloy. And why have I picked this alloy? Well, in the Iron Man film from 2008, Tony Stark mentions that the outside of the suit is made from a gold titanium alloy, not once, but twice.
Connect to the Cisco, have it reconfigure the shell metals, use the gold titanium alloy from the Seraphim tactical satellite. That should ensure fuselage integrity while maintaining power to weight ratio. Got it?
Iron Man, that's kind of catchy. It's got a nice ring to it. I mean, it's not technically accurate to see it's a gold titanium alloy, but it's kind of evocative, the imagery, anyway.
Here's your alibi.
Number four, and the final number for my calculation, well, that is the density of this gold titanium alloy. And to get a number for this, I'm going to turn to another scientific paper. This is the paper I've turned to in search of the density of a gold titanium alloy, a paper from 2016 where the researchers explored different ways of mixing gold and titanium to make new alloys. In the paper, there's a graph showing how the hardness of the alloy varies with changes in the amount of gold and titanium in the alloy. And here it is. The graph shows the variation in hardness of different alloys. The points of interest here are the solid red dots, as these are associated with the numbers from the research presented in the paper. I'm looking for their gold titanium alloy with the highest hardness because we'd like to protect the wearer of the suit as much as possible. And this is the value on the curve, as you can see right at the top. The highest hardness value corresponds to a density of just under 8 grams per centimeter cubed, or just under 8,000 kilograms per meter cubed. For ease of calculation, I'm going to assume that the density of the gold titanium alloy is 8,000 kilograms per meter cubed. So here's a summary of the assumptions I've made to calculate the mass of the Iron Man suit. Number one, I'm assuming that the surface area of the skin on the outside of the human body is 2 meters squared. Number two, I'm assuming that the average thickness of the suit is 5 centimeters. Number three, I'm going to use a material for the suit and say it's entirely made of a gold titanium alloy. And number four, the density of that gold titanium alloy is 8,000 kilograms per meter cubed. With all of this information, I can now calculate the mass of the suit. But before I calculate the mass of the suit, I want to first of all calculate the volume of the suit. And the volume of the suit is just the product of the surface area and the thickness of the suit. The surface area in this case is 2 meters squared. The thickness of the suit is 5 centimeters or 0.05 meters. And the product of those gives me the volume, which is 0.1 meter cubed. Now I've got the volume of the suit and I've got the density of the suit. I've all I need to calculate the mass of the suit. Mass, density, and volume are all related to each other by this equation. Density is equal to mass divided by volume. Rearranging the equation leads to mass equal to density multiplied by volume. And if I fill in the values for the Iron Man suit and I multiply the density by the volume, that will give me a mass of the suit of 800 kilograms. 800 kilograms is a huge value. To put it in perspective, it's about the same mass as a small car. 800 kilograms is also a huge overestimate on my part for 3 main reasons. Number one, the suit is not made from just a gold titanium alloy. Number two, the thickness of the suit all the way around is probably not 5 centimeters everywhere. And number three, the material doesn't have to be a solid block. It could be some sort of a lattice material that might look something like this, where there's lots of empty space, and this material can be very strong. You could even 3D print this type of material. And if it's filled with lots of empty space, well, that means, of course, that the mass of the suit will decrease drastically. Because if the suit had a mass of 800 kilograms, that would be extremely difficult to fly. Imagine trying to maneuver a suit that's 800 kilograms through the air. It's almost impossible. So was the CEO of New Line Cinema right to let the film rights of Iron Man lapse? Well, probably not, given how successful the films have been and how much money the studios who made the Iron Man films have made from the films. To be honest, New Line Cinema, that was a bit of a mistake. A massive mistake. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist. Thanks for watching this video. Be sure to stay tuned for more videos on superheroes, science, Star Wars, and even Santa Claus. And until I see you next time, always think super.